Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Place, the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We got a nice, nifty little streak going here. Let's try not to ruin it as Samson. The odds are, and I know I'm jinxing myself if you believe in the jinx, 1NNK E7S9. The odds are that we're probably not going to be in as tight of a spot as we were on that last Eve run. And that was pretty much my own fault. I mean, it would have been much easier. Oh my god, Rob. I want to talk to you about Magic the Gathering, but not like this. Not like this. We got something? Nope. That Eve run would have been a lot better if we had just not done... Well, it would have been a lot safer. Better is a little bit debatable. If we had just not done the boss rush room. But where's the fun in that? We got all sorts of greatness as a result of that. We got money equals power. Money equals power then, you know, worked together with the quarter that we picked up and allowed us to kill Blue Baby very, very easily. Speaking of money equals power, what do we get early? It is enough money to buy a spirit heart. And enough money to buy a spirit heart early is valuable in case you want to hurt ourselves on this floor to get the damage bonus. But more accurately, what we should probably do is save our money on the first floor. That's an okay item. Well, the hourglass is what I picked up in case you're just listening. The hourglass is okay if we don't have any other spacebar items to choose from here. It's got a two-room charge, so with the 9-volt, we can use it basically every single room. Literally every single room. At least at every single room that we do fine on. I wanted to take some damage there just to get a small damage bonus because we had some extra HP there. By every room that we do fine on, I mean every room that we actually finish. Like, if we bomb our way out. I don't know what do fine was supposed to mean, but anyway. Let us just end this room and move along here. We could even take more damage on this floor if we wanted to, but without having other red hearts, I don't think it's a particularly smart idea. Maybe if our, 9 volts, not our 9 volt, maybe if our item room had given us, like, piggy bank or something like that, or if we'd somehow gotten, swallowed penny. But we didn't. So instead, we'll just keep moving and hoping for a bomb and a tinted rock here. Bomb and a tinted rock. No bomb. No tinted rock. This is okay. Mostly just a miasma of boredom on that room, and then we get Larry Jr. And Larry Jr., you know, I'm not gonna say he gets freaking hard countered by the hourglass. I mean, it's only gonna keep him slow for like 2 or 3 seconds here, and then when he goes fast, inevitably he's gonna hit me again. Damn, baby, I can't do it that fast, but I know somebody who can. You know, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I got you looking at the glyphs on my hands and wrists. We all know the lyrics. Except for the ones in the middle where he talks, like, really fast. In which case, those are indecipherable. It's like, hit the stoplight, bump into some Isley, the beat's still moving, so I bump a little spinners, and I'd be boop-a-doop-a-doo, with, like, rolling through the streets, bumping 23s, sipping Hennessy, and it's like, please, Twista, why do you have to advocate drunk driving? Maybe your limo driver is driving, and you're just sipping Hennessy in the backseat? I don't know. I should have taken a little bit more damage before I picked that up. I guess it doesn't matter. We do want the bombs now. I forgot we got bombs out of that. Oh, careful of that one. I always find it interesting what, like, alcohol brands get associated with hip-hop. I don't think there has ever been a hip-hop song that I've heard that has glorified beer in any form. Is that, like, because it's too closely associated with, like, country music or something like that? There's never been, like, a hip-hop song where, like, Jay-Z comes on and goes, like, Bud Light Lime! We got Bud Light Limes popping off in the club. Everybody's making love. I don't know, man. Even, like flavored liqueurs always show up. Roll up to the crib with the bottle and James. I'm off the bus with the Alizé. You know, there's all sorts of that stuff. I know that that's a satire, but anyway. You get what I'm getting at. There's drinks that are not necessarily always associated with masculinity, but I guess they're associated with partying. We have ads. I've seen them, like, from pictures in the United States as well, but because I live in Vancouver, I will tell you that I've seen ads in Vancouver that are basically just, like, the most brazen Smirnoff Ice marketing campaigns I've ever seen in my life. Oh, fuck yes. D6 hourglass turns into piggy bank. Who would have thought? Smirnoff Ice, in case you're not familiar, in case you had the impression of alcohol that I did, when I was like 14, which was basically just whatever the alcohol commercials say. It's like, man, if you drink Smirnoff Ice, you'll get laid. I mean, they can't legally say that, but come on, that's what they're saying. Smirnoff Ice is basically like alcoholic lemonade, would be the way that I would describe it. I don't have anything against it. I don't like it, but if you like it, I could give two shits, basically. You know, I'm happy that you found something you enjoyed in this life. We spend, far too little time on this mortal coil for me to get bent out of shape about what you enjoy putting inside of your body. Especially when it's 100% legal. But anyway, what I'm getting at is that the ads are basically just billboards that have someone pouring, not even someone, just like a disembodied hand pouring a full bottle of Smirnoff Ice into a cup that, let's be honest, contains beer. You know how I know it contains beer? Because the ad in bold text contains only three words. Ice your beer, period. As if it's like a Yvonne Etniage style command uttered to your super conscious. Every time I just like go by the billboard, and there's a lot of them, I just want to be like, no. I don't want to ice my beer. I would rather drink just a Smirnoff Ice. And again, it's not my favorite. I would rather just drink a Smirnoff Ice than pour, you know, drink half of like a delicious beer and then pour the rest of a Smirnoff Ice in it. It doesn't make any sense to me why I would conflate that. I don't. It's like it was an ad for like Black Diamond Cheese, which is a popular cheese company in Canada. And, you know, there was just somebody pouring, like, a handful of shredded cheese onto a bowl of cereal. And it was like, cheese your cereal! You're like, what are you fucking talking about? Cheese my cereal, you fucking weirdo? I'm not gonna cheese my cereal, Black Diamond. That's ridiculous. But that's, to me, that's what that ad feels like. Whether or not that's what they're going for is a completely other question altogether. I'd guess probably not. It just strikes me as such a brazen ad. Like, who's gonna see that and be like, yeah, I had never thought about icing my beer before, but thank you, you know, disembodied Smirnoff ad. I will totally ice my beer. Explosive diarrhea? Are you fucking kidding? Oh, we got a secret room out of it, though. That was incredibly unexpected. So here's what we do. We pop down explosive diarrhea, and then we leave, and we blow that guy up for free, and get two spiders. There's our 20th cent as well. No arcade bums me out pretty hard. This is a freaking library then, right? Because we spawned like down here. Yeah, and a keybagger. So I did go to the library instead of going to the shop. My thinking being, might have a small chance. Just a small chance of getting some good stuff here. Check this shit out as well. We got the Bible. Let's fly back here. Gives us 5 extra cents, basically. And then we still have one reroll that we could use on the deal with the devil if we wanted, because we're going to get one. Or we could use it on the library again and get another 6 books thrown into our rotation here. I picked up the battery with the Bible. Oh, my fucking brain. Oh, I was so smart until I was so stupid. It's so much better for us to reroll the devil room if we want to. So I think it's 100% that I have to go up there and check that out. As much as I might like the idea of getting a full-on, you know, sweet-ass library early on, it is in our best interest to, you know, do things in the proper order. There's procedures and, you know, best practices outlined for stuff like this. The chances for us to become, you know, substantially closer to becoming Guppy or getting a Brimstone or a Mom's Knife or a Pact or a Mark or Death's Touch, etc., etc., they outweigh knocking a few more books out of the rotation. But I hope we just get good items on our deal with the devil to begin with so that we do have the ability to get the best of both worlds here. That was so stupid of me to squander that battery charge. Happy with the extra cube of meat and spirit heart? Okay, well here, this time I think we want the hairball, we reroll the other two. And we got Death's Touch and Rotten Baby, which are both worth taking. So sadly, our dream of a library completely taken care of already is gonna go. That's okay. Instead, we're gonna stick with all these amazing items that we got and probably still feel very, very good about it. Now, admittedly, it is gonna be tough for us to get constructive Bloody Lust help here. But on the other hand, we do have Rotten Baby and Death's Touch. So we don't really need the damage bonus from Bloody Lust as readily as we would have on our last floor. So I'm feeling very good about this regardless. We'll come back for that bomb, I'm sure. And now we have like really high damage piercing shots, a Guppy item, and, you know, if I'm being honest, probably the best familiar in the game, maybe. It's up there, at least. Rotten Baby has saved me a lot of heartache on many, many different runs. Let us just not take damage on this floor. It's also, you know, you could say that it's debatable. But I'm not the only one. We could have taken Book of Belial, and then that's nonstop deals with the devil, right? We would have missed out on Death's Touch as a result, which sounds like it's cost prohibitive, but honestly, it could end up being worth it to miss Death's Touch, and then, you know, have nonstop deals with the devil after it. I like the, you know, bird in the hand instead of two in the bush. That just sounds crowded, to be honest with you. Hopefully by going to a library, we give ourselves, like, some fictional kind of, like, library precedent that allows us to go to more libraries in the future. I don't know if that's a real thing, but how sweet would it be if it was? I do want to go to the curse room as well. It's pretty much, when you pick up a guppy item, you sign a contract, informally. Which, informal contracts don't exist that much. But, you sign an informal contract that basically says, I will pledge to go to every single curse room that will not literally kill me. So, we're sunk in, man. Hopefully we get HP here. We could really use it. It's not like an Eve situation, so the HP is there. And we're gonna fight Krampus, which is the other, like, best of all worlds. Oh, we got out just in time. And then we got back in just in time. And Lump of Coal's very nice. I'm not gonna reroll that. I'm very happy with our situation right now. Even though we have a pretty good chance to, you know, keep ahead of the pace for Boss Rush, I'm gonna choose to ignore that for now. In favor of, hopefully... Oh, that was just the worst bomb. What was I thinking on that one? In favor of hopefully giving us a better chance of getting some more stuff on this floor. I'm not going to sweat Boss Rush as much. I mostly just want to make sure that we, you know, give it our all to get to the item room. This is great. Basically, this is an extra item room, and we also just found the possibility of a black market, which there was. Okay, interesting. What do we have down here? Compass, PhD, BFF... Jesus, man. Well, we might as well play you twice. Get some extra money out of that. Then blow you up. Pick these. Out of all these, I'm thinking it's BFF or PhD. And I think I'm gonna go PhD. Need the survivability a little bit more than I need, like, tier damage right now. And then we're gonna leave. We can always come back if we get more HP, which is completely plausible, because re-rolling the shovel could turn it into Black Lotus or Raw Liver. Turn it into blank card. It's very interesting. That's the first black market I've had in quite some time. We did get a key out of it, though, so now we can go to our shop and then our item room, hopefully, after that. Trading a full spirit heart there scares the ever-living fuck out of me. More bombs. The other thing about going to the shop instead of the item room is that we would really, really like to buy some spirit hearts. It wouldn't be the worst thing in the world to buy a battery charge either, so I'm interested in this. Plenty of things we'd be interested in. We'll see. We do get a key. And we do get a spirit heart. And we get a pill for 48-hour energy. Basically couldn't ask for more here. I think we want to reroll... the secret room, unless the item room is... Well, no, I think we want to reroll the secret room either way for the potentiality to get a really, really good item. You know, we could get Skeleton Key, we could get Black Lotus, we can get Raw Liver, there's plenty of amazing stuff there. Strange Attractor Death's Touch is one of the better Strange Attractor synergies, so I'm just going to live with it for now. And we'll pop 48-hour energy, two batteries out of it. We got Necronomicon, which at least allows us to take another book out of the situation, which is valuable if we get more books in the future. The pennies are not worth it. Mr. Mega is better. Is it what I wanted? No, of course not. But it's up there. It's a real shame we didn't get what I wanted there. I would have loved to have picked up BFF, but that's okay. Wait a minute. Strange Attractor freaking sucks with Death's Touch. We don't have the scythes anymore. Our hitbox gets way smaller. That's not our second secret room locations. Are you high on my farts? I know that makes no sense. Okay. Still good. Not gonna lose out too much on the, you know, damage. We only got hit a couple times on the last floor. Let's be honest, you know, even if we lost our, the size of our tears, we still have the potency of them, basically. Still piercing shots, one way or the other. We have an arcade and a boss trap room. Ooh, a little scary. We want as many pills as possible, because, of course, we have PhD. They haven't really turned out the way I wanted them to yet. No arcade, no judgment in there. This is getting a little frightening. At least these enemies are going down quickly. Adding to the fear factor a little bit here is the fact that we have no, well, I shouldn't say no. I kind of mean this in the inverse way. We have a very great chance of getting a deal with the devil on this floor. We do have some chance of not getting one, but we're probably going to get one. But we're only really going to be able to afford it if we get HP beforehand, and then we could reroll it into a one-heart deal. Reroll our existing deals into one-heart deals. But I'd like to just be able to pick up whatever we find, because I don't want to be forced into rerolling a guppy item. It's another speed up, so I'm pretty stoked about the way the PhD has worked out for us on this floor so far. HP or balls of steel would be so meaningful, though. I will take it. I don't think it's that good, but I'll take it. A little chubby. I'm not in the position to argue against right now. So we'll take Rusted Key for more keys and more chests. I know that it's kind of a big risk over Rosary Bead, but hey, there you go. It's already paid for itself. What do you mean that's anecdotal evidence? No, this is unquestionably the right decision. What do you think? Second secret room over there? Like, that's why I'm holding Hematemesis, is the hopes of getting the Eternal Hearts. Oh, this could be it. Just gave myself a requisite arm scratch, followed by a bunch of red hearts we can't do anything with. Yet. Let's focus on the positive. Alright, the Hollow is completely screwed. If not by our piercing shots, then by our Mega Bombs. Got HP without a deal with the devil. Kind of a surprise. But at least we have a little bit more survivability, and maybe it's a blessing in disguise that we... Oh, you know what? We technically did get a deal with the devil on the last floor in the form of that Krampus fight. I forgot that it doesn't only apply if you, like, took a deal with the devil. Like, paid health for a deal with the devil. It applies either way. I'm thinking that probably we're going to have to pay a spirit heart to go to this curse room. That's okay. That sucks. It's getting less okay by the second here as our HP dwindles, but at least we have some refillable HP now. There's options, kind of a no-brainer pickup right now. Our pill is telepills. Worth a shot, I think. Okay. Honestly, a consumable kind of grab bag is not that bad of a haul. Do we want to do boss trap room? I kind of don't not want to do it. It's a roundabout way of saying I don't really want to do it, but I don't really not want to do it either. Stars? We just use that to get out. Yeah, you know, let's open the chest and then use the stars to get out. This is just a colossal failure. I think it's better to hedge our bets here. Alright, down to the next floor. I'm going to go back and get Hematemesis. It's not like Boss Rush is something I'm considering on this floor. Where the heck did I put Hematemesis? It must be in our shop? I want Hematemesis because it's like 4 HP upgrades potentially in waiting. I mean, for it to pay out with 4 HP upgrades would be pretty unprecedented, but you get the idea. You think this could be a second secret room? It wasn't, in case you were watching and wondering. We already found our second secret room, you dingo. I know we could play our blood bank a little bit as well, but that seems like it might be worth it, but it'll be very time consuming for the potential benefit of it. Alright, down to the next floor. Still on a very, very difficult, playing field here when it comes to our HP. But our damage is at least decent. You might argue that it's even better than I'm giving it credit for right now. You may very well be right, but, you know, you're watching and I'm playing. Which is not to say that I know better. All it means is that I know, you know, the way that I feel. And I feel some uneasiness in this run right now, largely, I think, as a result of our diminished HP. You don't necessarily, you might, but you don't necessarily have that same sense of uneasiness from being in the, you know, the driver's seat that I have right now. Although sometimes I'll admit, you know, when you're in control of the situation, you feel a little bit more in control than if you're just watching helplessly. But right now I'm feeling a little bit uncomfortable. There's a lot of things that can make that go away, though. A little bit more HP, 9 lives pick up on this floor, lots of spirit hearts, or a really good defensive or offensive item. Or even just a second secret room that has an eternal heart on it allows us to pretty much swing this around. Like, this pill could be a game winner, basically. Or, you know, the other thing is we might just not need anything. We might be totally fine, and I'm sort of exaggerating here, unintentionally, what the conditions of our run are. Rotten Baby, you need to really get those flies in there as soon as possible, especially when Strange Attractor kind of comes into play here. All right, item room, Infestation 2. Huge offensive item, big plays. Especially because we're killing a lot of enemies in one or two hits, this is a big help. Ghost is not dead. There we go. Trying to get like a Hierophant card or something, or just a black heart would be fine as well. We got one spider or zero spiders there. Either way, that's a honky-tonk badonkadonk right there. Take the map. Could use the spirit heart, but we'll take the map. And this is like a very weirdly linear floor. I like it. Not interested. What I mean by that is that, you know, we have missed a couple of rooms, but we know that we haven't missed any special rooms because they're all rooms that we've identified by being adjacent to them. So pretty much there's just like one spiral on this room and or on this floor, and then we just follow that all the way down here. We'll fight our boss. Good chance at a deal with the devil. Let's check for a second secret room because we have to. We got enough bombs. Yeah, this actually seems like the most likely place right here. Okay. And what I meant by that is, oh, there's no doubt it's right here. Should have put that closer. Actually, it got all of them anyway. Okay, we'll use Hematemesis here. It's not the Eternal Hearts that I wanted, but it's pretty good. It might even be better, actually. We got four Black Hearts additional out of that, which is really, really surprising. That's the best possible Hematemesis payout. So I'm pretty stoked. Oh, move! I'm pretty stoked about that. Certainly could have gone a lot worse. Trying to get this guy like close enough to an edge that I can use a Mr. Mega Bomb and possibly get a Spirit Heart from the Blue Fire as well. But we're gonna be fine. We're gonna be fine. And we got. Oh my God! What did we just? He extinguished it. He did it again. Oh, we want Caffeine Pill here, of course. Speed up. Well, hilarious. We could have rerolled both of them as well. You know, I love having HP, but the pentagram is well worth taking, not worth rerolling. So it's down to the next floor. HP is better. Survivability is better. Which I guess is what you would expect. Did damage get better? Yeah, damage did get better. By a lot. You know, pentagram helps out, but it's mostly Infestation 2 that's going to give me a lot more killing power than we've had previously. I am trapped as fuck. That's completely my own fault. This card could be useful. Strength. You know what? It is useful. We might, at the very least, be able to use that to play a blood bank. No, we're not going to get an arcade here. We could use it to cheese a deal with the devil, maybe? How do we do that? We would strength on the deal with the devil, and then reroll, and it should give us deals worth one red heart. And then when we take them, you know, it wouldn't effectively cost us anything because we didn't have that red heart to begin with. You know, we're buying something on credit card that we can't afford, basically. But they think we can. Not that I would ever advocate that, and that's not even a joke. You know, that shit is gonna land you in jail, and probably, well, deservedly so is not something I'm 100% comfortable saying, unless I know the specifics of your situation, in which case I will judge. However, let's just get off this subject altogether here. A rune. Bracano. Worth taking. Also worth leaving until the boss fight, but whatever, we'll hold on to it for now. Mr. Mega allowing us to get pretty good economy on our bombs. Help. So we got an item room in a shop. And one more dead end, potentially. That could give us, I don't know, maybe a library? We'll see. For now, this should be easy enough. Oh my God, he got very close. Looking for red chests there. Did not get them. There is a bomb I will go back for. We are... I was just about to say, I can't believe, or I couldn't believe, we wouldn't be fast enough to get through there without getting hit. Well, believe it, because it just happened. Somehow we were not fast enough to get through that without taking damage. There we go, one down, and huge amounts of spiders resulting from that. I'd like to take as many of them as possible, because we certainly don't need them to kill, kill Pin. We have to. I'm very sorry to our donation machine here, but the hive mind pickup is extraordinarily useful for us. Clearly have to go through with this. Gonna take a little while. 1 cent short, as we often are. And there we go. Thank you very much. Our spiders are now gonna be absurdly potent. Okay. What happens next? Well, we fake these guys out this time and then come through. They still almost got me. Check for a spirit heart. Probably could have put it in the middle and then gotten all four here. Got myself instead, so feeling pretty confident about that. Well, it looks like we got no other special room, so this will definitely be our item room, and that's PhD. Maybe hematemesis? I can't remember. Guillotine! I will take. Carries a risk, especially when your HP is low, but I appreciate the bonus that we get from it. And strength card. Still think this strength card could end up being worth its weight. Which it would be like, I don't know, 2 grams or something like that. You know, it's made out of cardboard. Probably not that heavy. It's more of a sentence that you'd use for like a big old ship or something like that. But, either way, I think it could be worth a lot on a deal with the devil if we ever get one. Which we don't have yet. We will take the Polaroid, because this run is kind of a little sketchy. And let's look at our map. I would guess that we're probably going far right into that little hairpin over there. And I'm still, you know, hoping for a guppy chance here, especially because we got Hive Mind. So if I can find a cursed room, I'd like to take advantage of it. Those are not red chests. I think it might still be worth it. We got Goathead. Goathead is worth 2 keys. And then the other consumables, you know, whatever. But the 2 keys, or the 1 key, I guess, for Goathead in this situation is very worthwhile. Gives us peace of mind that we're going to have a deal with the devil. We could even take a 3 spirit heart deal if it looks good, then strength, then reroll, and have like the best of both worlds. Nice little spider army for our next rooms as well, thanks to the chub kill there at the end. Still got a pretty good haul here. Let's not forget, I mean, we got a boss fight as well with their options, so there's a pretty good chance that we can get whatever item we want there. Really, really wanted this. That was bad. Really, really wanted this to be the boss room. Like, the one after this room, obviously. Instead, we took a little bit of damage, and that sucks, but... Hey, it gives us a little bit of damage as well, technically. Can't do anything about that tinted rock, unless we get the ability to... Pardon me, Guillotine? Unless we get the ability to fly on our next deal with the devil. And I'm watching this run slowly come apart. Scare me a little bit. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I don't want to do that room, so. Here we go. Conquest. I hate it. He's dead. He's not dead. I've gone back to hating it. I don't know. I don't know what we want here. Let's enter this room first. Oh, you dirty dog. I think we That's fine. Okay, we got some flies. I think we reroll both of these. And you know what? I think we take meat. I didn't really want HP. I would have preferred better DPS. But at least we got some DPS out of this. And I don't really think we needed White Pony. We definitely do not need speed at this point. Spirit Hearts. Well worth it. Holy crap. I mean, White Pony would have been okay. I did take the Pony at that boss fight on our last run. And I think it ended up helping us. But I'd prefer to have the D6. I also didn't give up the D6 for the pony on our last run. I gave up, like, Guppy's head. Guppy's head is fine. It's good. It's just not as good as the D6. This feels like a secret room. That's fine. It's fine. Especially if you don't take damage on it, it's fine, as far as I'm concerned. It also allows us to skip this room on the way to what I presume is the boss fight. Still got this strength card. One day. One day we'll find a way to use it. And this was indeed the right way to go. So, you know, fighting greed might have been a win-win for us there. There we go. Get the spiders in there. We've already taken off a lot, but it's really going to start to dip for him. For Mom's Heart, I guess I should say, when the spiders start dropping. And the flies aren't too shabby either. A little bit of damage, that's okay. Still getting adjusted to the guillotine dodge. It's a little trickier. Alright, on the cathedral. Definitely not bottom right, so we're looking at all the way up to the... Bottom left, I should say. We're looking at all the way up to the top here. It's going to be a long trek. That's okay. I have packed many calorically dense snacks, such as almonds. What the fuck am I talking about? This is, my brain is on full Isaac mode. It can't focus on cogent conversation. Land. Some fucking spiders. We don't have any fucking spiders. Just let me out, dog. Do we really need to be here? Got hit once. We are not in a concerning amount of HP right now. We're fine. For now. This could change pretty quickly. We get hit like 3 times. Start to think we're not so fine. Don't jump. Oh, the spiders, they do so much. And the flies as well, when they work. Sometimes they aggro, strangely. You know what? Strange attractor makes this dangerous. I don't think I got hit there. Strange attractor makes things dangerous, but also good. Gotta do it. 3, 4. Why am I counting the amount of money? I could just look at the amount I've donated. You dick. Oh, you did it. HP. Just give me the HP, dog. I need it now. 2 HP is better than 1 right now. Oh, yes! That is right, I did it! Spirit Heart, are you kidding me? Luckfoot is fine. At this point, we took it, okay. At this point, I feel like Luckfoot is a really smart take because we get more chests on the chest as a result. So we could reroll that item, but it means losing out on more items in the future. Is that worth it? I don't think so. I could be wrong, though. I would get rid of this strength card for an emperor card, a world card, something along those lines. But we'll see. It's a second strength card. I would get rid of the strength card for a strength card because it means we can use it on this boss fight. I think we're going to be fine on the cathedral here. We don't really need that. So let's pop our strength card. Okay. That was a very strange dodge on my part. Pretty lucky to get out of it without running into trouble, I think. You know what? With Guillotine, we're very lucky our speed stat is so high that even when my dodges are terrible, they're not that bad. Now, if I'd known we would have taken Guillotine, would I have taken BFF instead of PhD? I mean, PhD, if we're being honest, it's not worked out that well. Whole hell of a lot of speed upgrades, that's about it. BFF could have been better. Really would have helped out Cube of Meat and our own head. That's the draw there. Who comes next? Well, we skip Azazel, so it'll be a Lazarus run next. I'm feeling good, man. Like, this is feeling more like the old streak to me, is like dangerous runs where, honestly, I don't feel that much in danger anymore. I feel like Rusted Key is what we want to roll with here. Just so we can get more chests on the chest, probably. Might as well check both. Ah, that's not going to be second secret room. Here we go. Down to the next floor. This is for all the marbles. No curse, ideally. Don't cuss! Curse of Darkness. The best of the curses, if I'm being honest. Spider Butt. Onk. Cancer Pickup. Scapular. Well, we'll take the Cancer Pickup. We'll take Scapular. We'll take the Onk, just in case. And we'll reroll that. And I think rerolling it into Gimpy with our luck stat as it is okay. I would classify that as like a solid B tier chest drop. Or chest drops. I don't think that's too bad. Ansu's Rune. That gives us complete vision. Now we know exactly where we need to go, so we can skip, hopefully, some terrible rooms. This one is also terrible, though. It's, like, real bad. But our HP is not. Our HP is now actually half decent. And on top of that... Oh, that was not so smart. On top of that, we've got the damage bonus from Bloody Lust and the ability to come back to life as Blue Baby once we die. Did we just get hit twice there, or did we bounce him off both times? Okay, I figured one of them had to be close to death. No bombs, so we're taking the long way. Yeah, definitely this is where you want to kill Sloth last, if you can wrap your dome around it. Oh, thank you, Gimpy. Gimpy paying out exactly the way I needed it to. Bob's Rod and Head. A very good reroll target for us. Hopefully some spirit hearts here, or maybe lard would be fine. All right, that's okay. Can't do anything about it, but... Or can't do anything about it, so we should just accept it, I suppose. You know what? I don't mind using a bomb to maybe speed this up. Oh, I don't have one. I left it on the last room. That's all right. We'll use it to get to the secret room instead. We've been hit enough to up our damage bonus. We're getting into some good territory. Why would I not dodge there? That's a fantastic question I don't have the answer to. What I will point out is that we actually basically have the wafer effect because of the cancer pickup, so that is a pretty stellar get for us here. Fairly tough chest so far. If we had this amount of damage on our Eve run, we probably would have ended up losing, or at least being at much greater risk of losing. By the way, thanks to Luckfoot for all the chest drops we're getting here. Big help. Much appreciated. Ouija board, huge, man. There's so many rocks on the chest that my sarcasm knows no bounds. We are not flying, so just, you know, still endeavor to stay out of the creep down there at the bottom. There we go, finally. And by finally, I mean literally like 20 seconds earlier than we normally would kill Mega Fatty. But still, okay, we're good. Item, no item. Here we go. The dream is alive. Pop the strength card. That was our only bomb. Make sure we get the flies in there. We have no invincibility, but we do have the cancer effect. Oh man, those spiders, so good. Ooh, surprisingly easy blue baby fight, but for now, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. We're building up somewhat of a respectable streak here. What are we at now? 13. We'll be back with a Lazarus run next. For now, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, I'll see you next time. See ya then.